is upon us once more. And to gear ourselves up for the best holiday of the year, sorry Christmas, we've been watching all sorts of spooky films. And of course, we couldn't help but make a list of our favorite horror movie cars. Number 10, a car tire, rubber. Okay, so perhaps a murderous tire isn't officially a car, but we don't play by the rules here at miDrive, and the idea of a killer wheel is too bonkers for us to pass up. Rubber is about a tire that possesses the ability to make people's heads explode. You know, like the movie Scanners, if Daryl Revok happened to be a car tire.
Hey, wait! It's not the end! He's been reincarnated as a tricycle!
Number 9. Mercury Marquis, Stakeland. Road movies would be nothing without cars, and Mister's car of choice to traverse through the vampire apocalypse in search of a safe haven is a 69 Mercury Marquis, which spits and sputters its way nobly through two-thirds of the movie before coming to its untimely demise. Whilst it doesn't quite have the panache of later entries, its grungy simplicity is perfect for such a bleak film. Number 8. Jaguar XJ12, Shaun of the Dead.
You didn't tell me Barbara had a Jag. You know, I've always wanted to drive one of those.
Okay, so perhaps Philip's Jaguar XJ12 isn't particularly integral to the movie, but it's a bloody nice car, and boy does he know it. Despite trying his utmost to keep his car in the most pristine condition possible, and who wouldn't with a car like that, it ends up being Ed's car of choice to tackle the horde of zombies standing between our heroes and the Winchester. Unfortunately, I get the feeling all the blood and guts spattering the car might affect its resale value. Number 7. Monster Truck, Monster Man.
Shut up. If a vehicle could take Viagra, a monster truck is what it would look like.
It's hard to mistake a monster truck for anything but a monster truck, so when said truck is fitted with a body that seems to resemble the skull of a giant mecha wolf and an engine that runs on rocket fuel, it becomes pretty eye-catching. Such a unique look comes with a price, however. Despite the fact that the body was made of painted wood, the truck could only run for a maximum of half an hour before overheating. Number 6. Cadillac Escalade, Zombieland. When you're trying to get through the inevitable zombie apocalypse, a decent zombie-proof ride is essential. And Tallahassee's Escalade is a perfect example of this. If the Escalade alone wasn't robust enough to survive the apocalypse, the snowplow mounted on the front will make sure any zombies that get knocked down stay down.
I mean, do what you want with a man, but do not fuck with his Cadillac.
The only way a car would be more suited for a zombie apocalypse is if it were a 50-foot, heavily armored, weaponized lorry. And that's just silly. Or maybe it isn't. Number 5. Dead Reckoning, Land of the Dead. Dead Reckoning, a 50-foot, heavily armored, weaponized lorry, is what would happen if you took a train, made it roadworthy, and fed it steroids. Equipped with two machine guns, a pair of remote-controlled miniguns, and a pair of roof-mounted rocket launchers, it'd probably be horrendously tricky to drive. But at least you wouldn't need to worry about road rage when you're driving that thing.
Get a load of that nasty old thing. What is that, the vehicle of choice for assholes and fucking serial killers?
Number 4. Chevy COE, Jeepers Creepers. Fewer vehicles have had a better introduction than the 1941 Chevy COE that appears in Jeepers Creepers. Despite being a grubby, rusted tank of a truck, it manages to take siblings Trish and Derry by complete surprise, with the help of the world's most terrifying horn.
What the hell's his problem?
Just get out of his way, Derry!
More resembling an industrial furnace on wheels than a vehicle, it's hard to mistake this van, especially with its rather unique license plate.
Remember when I said this car was death-proof? Well, that wasn't a lie. This car is 100% death-proof. Only to get the benefit of it, honey, you really need to be sitting in my seat.
Number 3. Chevrolet Nova, Dodge Charger, death-proof. Stuntman Mike actually goes through two cars in Tarantino's death-proof, a 71 Chevy Nova and a 69 Dodge Charger. Whilst the Nova is probably the more identifiable of the two, thanks to the skull and lightning motif emblazoned on the hood, it's the Charger that really takes center stage in the second half of the movie, after Mike chases down and proceeds to get chased down himself, four friends driving a Dodge Challenger. Number 2. Plymouth Fury, Christine. There aren't many horror movie vehicles as iconic as Christine, everyone's favourite killer car. The film was originally adapted from a Stephen King story, and while the original car was a Plymouth Fury, more often than not, the film used modified Belvederes and Savoys instead. Owning a car capable of communicating with you exclusively via songs from the 1950s must be quite a novelty, but the inevitable police investigation probably isn't worth it. Number 1. Oldsmobile Delta, Evil Dead franchise. Just pipping Christine to the post is Ash's yellow Oldsmobile Delta 88, nicknamed the Classic. This Oldsmobile has cameoed in every single film Sam Raimi has made since The Evil Dead in 1982, in various states of repair. The most unique incarnation of Ash's car, however, has got to be its appearance in the second sequel, Army of Darkness, in which Ash pimps it out with all the anti-zombie weaponry you can think of. Your move, exhibit. And that brings us to the end of our Halloween-themed Top 10 Horror Movie Cars list. If you have any car-related Top 10 lists you want us to cover, leave us a comment, and don't forget to subscribe. Happy Halloween.
How's that for a slice of fried gold?
Yeah, boy!